Friends, welcome back to my channel. In last video we created this clock, and today we will increase the minutes and hours increment function using these micro switches. We will use two micro switches and two 10 kilo ohm resistors, and we need some jumpers. How we will make connections? We will use digital read function, and we will take 5 volt here, and we will use 10 kilo ohm resistor, and we will feed it to the digital IO pin, and we will take digital read function here, and we will monitor the condition, and then we will use here a switch push button. Normally it will remain high. When we will press it, at that time our conditional statement will active and it will start increasing the minutes. The same two assignments we will use. Let's make it. I will remove power. Now we need to take these 5 volt and ground that are going from Arduino board to the LCD. We will place in the rail. We will bring positive voltage from the board, positive 5 here. We will bring the ground. Now we will use a 10 kilo ohm resistor for digital IO. We will use this resistor and we will place in from positive, and we will connect the switch 1 end to this resistor. Yes, it is pressed. And we will place the other switch closer to this button, push button, and we will place the second resistor to this button, and we will place it to the positive rail. Yes, the boards now pulled up. So we will provide this pulled up signal. We will take from this point and we will feed to the Arduino. The minute setting we will provide to digital IO pin number 2, and hours we will make setting from pin number 3. So this is our input. We will provide ground to the both side of switches, and this ground here. Positive voltage are reaching here and it is going to the LCD, and positive voltage are reaching to this resistor and this resistor. Yes, that's good. Ground is reaching to LCD and ground is reaching here, and we provided ground to both ends of the switches. Now I will apply power. Yes, this is the ground pin, and I will check that is going to the pin number 3. I will press. When I press it, it is going to low. When I will leave, it will go to high. Yes, it is now pulled up. And we will check the minute switch. It is normally high. When I will press it, it is low, going low. That's good. Let's write the code. So we give this signal to pin number 2, that is for minutes, and the second signal to pin number 3, that is for the hour setting. So we will assign some name, this button and this button, that is for hours, this is for minutes. We will assign the integer int in the declaration. We will assign a name, minutes, minute setting button. This is our button where we are connecting. It is pin number 2. Enter integer hours setting button, that is pin number 3. We assigned the name. Now come to the setup. Pinmode, what is the pin role? Pinmode minute setting button comma input. We declared that this is input pin, and we will bring this name our setting button, pinmode our setting button comma input. Yes, we defined here that these are input pins. Now come to the minutes counting block. When this argument will finish, after that we will enter a comment here. Minute increment block. We want to read the condition of the minute switch, what is that? Because we pulled it up, we will give integer here now. Integer minute setting minute button state. This is the initial condition because it is high. Why it is high? Because we pulled up, we say the initial condition, the switch will high, it is pulled up. With 10k resistor. Yes, this comment we added that it is pulled up, and we will add another statement for the hours button. Hours button state is equal to high because it is pulled up with 10k resistor. Now we will copy this function because we declared a state that this switch is initially high. And now we will compare this. Now come to the minutes increment block. We declared a position here that this switch is initially high. Copy it. Minutes here. Now we want to re-verify what is the current condition. Because it is digital IO pin, digital read, which pin, digital read, minute setting button. This is our minute setting button, digital read, bracket closed. We verified what is the position. Now we will create conditional statement. If minute button state is equal to low, yes, from here our system will start working. If minute button state is low, what to do? We want to make increment for the minutes. Minutes units is equal to minutes units plus 1. We said when this switch will low, if it is high, it will do nothing. But when it is low, we want to increase minutes plus 1. We want to make 1 increment. But here we want to give some debounce time. When we are using mechanical switch, it have a setting time, contact setting time. So we need contact setting time, that is debounce time, that is mechanical position changing from high to low. So we will say delay 100 millisecond or less than 100 millisecond, 100 millisecond, that is good. Just press it. It will take a slight delay, otherwise sometime it will make double counting. So we don't want to make double counting. We want to give a delay and then it will increase. Now we declared that minute button state is equal to digital read, this one, that our this integer which we declared in the top in the declaration. If it is low, give a delay 100 millisecond for debounce time for mechanical operation, and increase minutes units plus minutes unit is equal to minutes units plus 1. So this is our code, and colon is here, all terminators are here. Upload. Now it is 8:36. 8:37, 2 seconds, 8:38, 39, 40, increasing, yes, 42, 43. If I will keep it pushed, it will increase one by one. Yes, it is increasing. But now we can see the seconds are also changing. We don't want to increase the seconds. we will now write that when we will press this switch, the seconds must go to zero. After delay, we will say the second units. We will copy this statement, second units. Where is that? This is here. Second units is equal to zero and seconds tens is equal to zero. Okay, upload it. When we will press this button, after 100 milliseconds, it will make zero to these seconds. Let's upload it. Okay, 836. If I will press it, 37. And if it is pressed in, we can see now the minutes are increasing and seconds are 00. When I will leave, at that time the seconds will start to increase. So let's now copy this block and we will add it after the hour units. Copy it, minute tens, hour units, and we will add this block here. Why I am adding after this block? Because when it will increase, we will rename it hours increment block, and I will set this hours button state digital read hours button, hours setting button. If this is low, what to do? Delay this one. And we don't want to increase the minutes or anything. We will just add our units. We will add these two items, copy and paste. We will add 1 hour in hours and we will increase the 24 hour counting time with one. So let's upload it. Now this is our minutes button, 37, 38, 39, and this is our hours button, 9, 10, 11, 12. When it is 12, the time is changed to AM, 1, 2, 3, yes, it is increasing. When the time will reach at 11, after that it will move to 12 and AM will shift it to PM. Yes, PM, that's nice. So our this code is now working good. I will attach the link of this code in the video description. You can download it. If you have any observation, if you have any comment, if you have any suggestion, kindly let me know in the comment box. In our upcoming session, we will add the days counting, the date, the month counting. We will add these countings in our this clock. I hope so you enjoyed this video. If it is good, hit the like button. If you have any question, let me know in the comment box. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.